this, they feel very overwhelmed with it.
I love both of these ideas.
As like an app and like the way that we organize.
And I always tell people that I get way more out of this program than I was supposed to because I'm still here and I'm still involved.
The Yukio project is heart-driven. It's a good cause.
I think Phoenix had a viable concept and could defend it.
But the Phoenix project seems to have some solid framework.
And I think if they partnered with some organizations that know a lot more about this, this is the kind of thing that can make a difference in a short period of time. And frankly, something that they could do in 2020. This is something they could put to market in 2020 to help communication and collaboration.
So I think it was a great experience across the board for not only just us as panelists, but for the students as well.
And those are the kind of minds we want in our business.
Same thing on my side. We're looking for people who have big ideas and aren't afraid to chase them. People that have creativity, work ethic, discipline, creative skills. There's a lot of things I saw today.
And I mean, that's what JA is all about. It's to giving them the exposure to the leadership that's already out there to mentor them. And although we can't do it in person right now, this is the next best thing. And quite frankly, it works pretty well.
On behalf of one of the boards of Junior Achievement Tampa Bay, I'm the chair of that. I congratulate you on your accomplishments. Thank you for giving me the opportunity to share my thoughts with you today.
Yeah. All right, well, thank you guys so much. I appreciate your time and, you know, sharing your ideas and thoughts and expertise with these kids. It means a lot.
Thanks, Dawn.
Thank you.
All right.
Bye.
Bye-bye.